What's cooking, everybody? It's Dor, and today we will be covering the easiest and fastest way of reaching the center of any galaxy in No Man's Sky. Not only will we be going over how to get there, but I'll also explain why you would want to travel through the center, as well as give some tips on how to minimize the damage your components take by doing so. And so without any further ado, let's get straight into it. So as you may or may not know, No Man's Sky has more than one galaxy to explore. 255 of them, to be exact. Well, actually 257, but the last two are invite only. And to reach the next galaxy, you will have to travel to your current galaxy's core. Every player starts in the first galaxy, Euclid, approximately 700,000 light years away from its core, and it could take you hours of warping until you reach the center. Luckily, there is a way to get you very close to the core. You will need to have access to a portal and have the first glyph unlocked. I'll leave videos on how in the description down below. Once you've interacted with the portal, you want to insert only the first glyph. The portal will give you an error, but will connect you to a destination nearby. Go through the portal. On the other side of the portal, just get into your ship and take off. Once you're in space, open up the galaxy map. You'll see that we are now within 6,000 light years away from the galaxy's core, no matter which system you are in. Make sure you have the galactic core selected and warp as far as you can. The better your starship is upgraded, the further you can jump in one go. I'll also leave a video and the setup I'm using below. When you arrive in the system, open the galaxy map again. You may have to repeat this a couple of times before you actually arrive in a system within warping distance of the center of the galaxy. Just make sure you always have the galactic core selected as your destination. Once you are within warping distance, you'll notice that it will take longer than usual to select the next destination on the galaxy map. You would have to have your hyperdrive fully fueled to be able to warp into the core. But you don't want to do that. Back out of the galaxy map and summon your freighter. Jumping through a galaxy's core will damage all your installed technology in your general inventory for your starship, exosuit, and multi-tool. So I would personally advise to use a living ship to make the jump, as you can easily fit all or most of your tech in its technology inventory, as well as the added bonus of filling the entire hyperdrive up using only 60 chromatic metal. If you do not have a living ship, you could also use one of your lesser ships, like the starter ship the Radiant Pillar, for instance. Next to swapping your ship, I would also advise to swap your multi-tool to a different one. You can carry three, so make sure you buy one for this purpose. You could also put some of your exosuit stack in your technology slots, or make sure to carry resources to be able to repair them. Especially your shields, as you usually end up on a hazardous planet. So once you've done all the necessary prep work, it's time to start warping. Open the galaxy map and select the galaxy center. Select warp and enjoy the show. A message will appear to indicate which system you've reached, and you will spawn in a random system again approximately 700,000 light years away from its core. As mentioned earlier, all your technology in your general slots will be damaged and non-functioning. Swap out your broken multi-tool to be able to locate your starship. Depending on how far it exactly is and the planetary conditions, you could try to reach it without repairing your tech, but I wouldn't advise on doing this in a permadeath playthrough. While I'm going towards my starship, I want to ask you to please leave a like and or a comment if you found this video helpful in any way. And don't forget to subscribe to be informed on all things No Man's Sky, from beginner's guides to amazing starships and anything in between. As my primary jetpack is broken, it stopped indicating how much fuel I have left, which resulted in me almost killing myself. Once you've reached your ship, however, you are safe and have plenty of time to repair everything. You could also go to a space station to get supplies, or also be able to warp back into previously visited systems via the teleporter, as long as you've got a base there or have visited a space station. You could also track down another portal and use the same method to once again find yourself within 6,000 light years away from that system's core. Doing one after the other with broken technology could save you a lot of resources, but it is very risky. If you are using the setup from my video, you will have some shields in your tech slots, but not enough to withstand extreme storms. In which case, repair your technology as soon as possible. I'll leave all materials needed to do so on screen. But that was all for this video. Would you have expected that traveling to the core could be this fast and easy? Let me know in the comments down below, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thank you so much for making it this far into the video. If you liked it, make sure to leave a thumbs up and let me know in the comments down below. If you really did, please subscribe. And if not, well, I hope I get to convince you in the next video.